My name's Jordan Brown. I am the Raptor, Grassland, and Forest Bird Biologist for the Delaware Division of Fish and Wildlife, which is part of DNREC. We are here with Mount Cuba today. This is our third time out to actually band the kestrel chicks that are in a nest box. This is our third visit. They've had three different times of measurements, and now they're getting banded before they leave the nest. They're the smallest falcon in North America. You know, they're no bigger than a mourning dove, which is crazy to think that, you know, you think of a falcon and you think a very large bird. But this bird is, you know, can fit in my hand. They are sexually dimorphic. So the males and the females visibly look different. You can see that in the field when you're looking at these birds. The males have a very slate blue wing color. They're very hard to miss. And the females are a little bit more drab, but they have brown and dark brown, like checkered wings. You can see on the wing how there's both black and brown. If this was a male, this would all be slate blue. And she's got all of the same pattern going down her back. And eventually her head will have the tiniest bit of slate blue helmet, but she'll also have a brown, kind of like a little toupee up there. Each bird gets a unique numbered USGS band. It goes on their left leg. So that will be their unique identifier that gets sent through the federal system so that if we capture this bird again, or unfortunately if we find it dead, we're able to determine which bird that was. We additionally also have large yellow colored bands which go on the right side. And that is more so for field identification. People with binoculars and scopes, you'll be able to see those numbers. It's a three-digit number from the field, and they can actually report that through the same system, USGS, and it will come back to our program. So all of these data that are being submitted, the recapture data, each time we find a kestrel that has been banded, we're able to see where it came from, how old it is, whether or not it's productive and nesting, if we find it and it's dead, whether it's sick, hit by car, you know, all of those things. It gives us a lot of data, which ultimately provides a long-term data set for the conservation of this species. This region, the Mid-Atlantic region, has seen 95% declines over the last 30 years. So it is very important, the work that we're doing and the work that Mount Cuba is contributing to this project. And since we've started this program, we went from maybe 10 boxes in the ground to now upwards of 75. We're looking towards expanding into Kent and Sussex counties so that we can get a really good idea of what the kestrel population is doing across the state. We're primarily focused in the Newcastle County region right now. Additionally, I'm looking for volunteers, people who want to go out and, you know, look inside of these kestrel boxes and tell me what's going on. Are these kestrels nesting in them? Landowners who want to get involved with this program and have a nest box up, as well as people who want to make kestrel boxes but maybe don't want to be involved in another way. There's all kinds of ways we can be involved. And in the future, we're hoping to do some more things like tagging. There are things that we can do not only with bands on the legs, but little backpacks sort of that we can actually put on them that tells us where they go when they migrate. So that's kind of looking into long-term goals with this project, but overall we're very excited of how far we've come and, you know, how the future looks.